Commandant Air Marshal Hardeep Benz, distinguished faculty and participants of the 64th course of the NDC. It is an absolute privilege to share my thoughts on India, core values, interests, and objectives with this distinguished and globally representative audience. The subject bears contemporaneous relevance. India, with civilizational ethos of over 5,000 years, most populous nation, oldest and largest vibrantly functional democracy, on unprecedented economic upsurge, with phenomenal infrastructure taking place all around, is bound to evoke global interest and attention. Same is for its values, interests, and objectives. In a sense, there is interconnectedness between core values, interests, and objectives. First, I will indulge briefly on historical perspectives. India's core values for ages are foundation of its destiny. These are premised on our civilizational ethos and ascents. However, in the times we are living, these have emerged as a blend of ancient wisdom and modernity, aiming to fructify people's aspirations. India, home to 1/6 of humanity, is the spiritual capital of the world, cradle of sublimity and divinity. Its core values have taken shape in this backdrop. Being inspired by its core values, people have, over the ages, traveled to this land to quench their spiritual thirst and find solace for their souls, in the process also getting enriched and also enriched this land. I am contextually reminded of late Pranab Mukherjee's reflection while being president of the country. I quote, "This ethos of acceptance and assimilation has defined the Indian civilization and made it a melting pot of the world. We must nurture and preserve this spirit, which has made our country a rich amalgam of multiple cultures," unquote. India, land of historic knowledge centers like Takshila and Nalanda, on account of its soothing values, attracted inquisitive souls in search of enlightenment. Our core values emanate from our timeless treasures, Vedas, Upanishads, Puranas, epics, Ramayana and Mahabharata, as also Gita. Foremost core value is reflected in a shloka from Upanishad. I advert to that. Om Sarve Bhavantu Sukhinah, Sarve Santu Niramayah, Sarve Bhadrani Pashantu, Ma Kashchit Dukhah Bhagam Vet. This translates, may all be happy, may all be free from illness, may all see auspiciousness, and may none suffer. This profound prayer encapsulates the very spirit of India, a nation that seeks well-being not just for itself, but for the entire humanity. And the sweep is amplified in Vasudev Kutumbakam. The world is one family. This too has its origins in the Mahaupanishad, another ancient, timeless Indian text. Distinguished audience will recall this spirit also resonated and so continues in the theme of India's G20 presidency. The theme was One Earth, One Family, One Future. Despite centuries of aggressions, colonial disruptions, India's core values remained inextinguishable, and much of its knowledge has also endured these onslaughts. Cultural ethos and our values have survived onslaughts and sustained through the integration of ancient scientific rituals, spiritual ascents, and altruistic values in our system. After independence, a new chapter began on 26 January 1950, when Indian Constitution came into effect, state emblem was adopted, carrying motto, Satyameva Jayate. Truth alone triumphs. This is another inalienable facet of India's core values. Distinguished audience, preamble of the Indian Constitution sets out its guiding purpose and principles, and in a sense mirrors India's core values: secure to all its citizens, justice, social, economic, and political, liberty of thought, expression, belief, faith, and worship, equality of status and of opportunity, and to promote among them all fraternity, assuring the dignity of the individual and the unity and integrity of the nation. Recently, as I indicated, as G20 chair, India, spurred by its core values, championed a shift from GDP-focused to human-centered global progress, emphasizing unity over division. The wholesome objective was to transform international dialogue to serve the many, not the few, requiring fundamental changes in global cooperation, making it equitable. India's presidency, guided by inclusivity, ambition, action, and decisiveness, achieved unanimous support on issues of great importance through the New Delhi Leaders' Declaration. Integrating the African Union as a permanent G20 member was a landmark achievement, and all the more as European Union was already one. This led to inclusion of 55 African nations into the forum, enhancing representation to 80% of global population. Voice of Global South summits hosted by India during its G20 presidency brought Global South on international radar. The only constant in life is change. This is much referred to, a quote emanating from Heraclitus, pre-Socrates era philosopher. Same is true, distinguished audience, of our core values. While retaining their spine and essence, our core values have revealed adaptations and adjustments to be in sync with changing times and needs. So now, on India's core values in present times, democracy and pluralism, integral to these values, as the world's largest democracy. India celebrates its diversity with several official languages, multiple religions, varied ethnicity canvas under one constitution, ensuring freedom and equality. Peaceful coexistence finds reflection in our philosophy over the ages. India's foreign policy emphasizes respect for sovereignty, territorial integrity of nations, and more importantly, primacy of dialogue over conflict and contestation. Unity in diversity has been ever exemplified both in thought and action. India embraces differences across festivals all over the country, cuisines, languages, cultures, as strengths, inclusive and far distanced from divisiveness. Sustainability, be it in growth or environment, is a prism that guides our actions. Rooted in traditional cultural ethos of environmental harmony, India commits to containing and combating climate change that has emerged as existentially a global challenge. Our scriptures, saints and sages, all through our historical journey, advocated social justice. Now this is blossoming, being nurtured by way of constitutional safeguards and reforms for evolution of just and equitable order while addressing inequalities and iniquities through affirmative action. Distinguished audience, Indian Constitution provides for affirmative action for the vulnerable and the marginalized segments. This has now been taken to the next level. Universal well-being is at the heart of Indian philosophy. Focus on inclusive development, peace, and collective progress while nurturing the environment is finding reflection in multiple policy initiatives and innovative schemes. Distinguished audience, this takes me to India's interests. India's interests are driven by the welfare of its people, the global community, for global peace and harmony. India is known to have had the largest economy of the ancient and medieval world, controlling between one-third and one-fourth of the world's wealth. India obviously seeks to so attain this in present times. Thus, economic development is paramount and priority. With burgeoning population, India is focused on evolving as innovation hub. These are evidenced with initiatives like Make in India and Digital India, fostering innovation and entrepreneurship for its young population. Now there obtains in this country an ecosystem as a consequence of affirmative policies and innovative steps that allow citizens to fully exploit their potential, channelize their energy, and fructify aspirations. India is committed to gender justice, this being vital to economy and societal values as also harmony. This has resulted in not only empowerment of women, it has graduated to the next level, women-led empowerment. Distinguished audience, constitutional prescription of one-third reservation for women in Lok Sabha and state legislatures is both epochal and game-changer, with the prospect of larger participation of women in governance, policy-making, and administration. Massive phenomenal infrastructure growth and deep digitization has fueled our growth engines. Distinguished audience, you all are fully aware that peaceful environment is quintessence for growth. This orders the nation to focus on strategic security through strong defense capabilities while maintaining regional peace. Towards this, India has advocated on global fora adherence to rule-based order and need for connected dialogue, cooperation and consensus as against confrontation. Energy security is another crucial aspect. This is being taken care of with India diversifying into renewables to meet its growing needs. The development in this field has been exponential. Geopolitically, India promotes global stability through platforms like BRICS and G20, while also emerging as a technology leader in areas like space exploration and artificial intelligence. India's interests are people-centric growth, inclusive development, as also peace and harmony. To attain this, India has laid great emphasis that menace of terrorism and fundamentalism be combated in tandem and togetherness as a global challenge. I come to the next important aspect, India's objectives. Distinguished audience, India's objectives combine ambition with inclusivity across multiple domains. India aims to be a constructive global force through peacemaking, peacekeeping, and climate action initiatives. India's role as a first responder in any disaster, be it COVID, medical supplies, evacuation, high seas security, has been well recognized. The focus now is on poverty eradication and universal education. These are supported by programs like Skill India and Ayushman Bharat at grandiose level. India, distinguished audience, targets net zero emissions by 2070 and pursues sustainable development through initiatives like the International Solar Alliance. The vision of India's centenary of independence encompasses prosperity, self-reliance, advanced infrastructure, and technological leadership. These in togetherness will define Viksit Bharat at 2047. The core mission is uplifting every individual through healthcare, employment, and social development. The work is in progress and being fast-tracked by the day. Distinguished audience, in conclusion, India's core values, interests, and objectives resonate with the aspirations of the humanity as a whole. Vibrant democracy, civilizational ethos, and culture of peace, unflinching commitment to global harmony, cooperation, and peace uniquely position India as an indispensable player on the world stage. Collective effort is key to realization of this vision. Each one here, a distinct class, has a role to play in building an India that is not just prosperous, but also just, inclusive, and sustainable. as the nation moves for Viksit Bharat by 2047, we remember in this country that we do so not just for ourselves, but for the greater good of the world. Times to vigorously engage in shaping future for posterity as trustees. Peace disruption or conflagration in any part of the globe has potential to upset and unsettle growth, harmony and development, disrupt supply chains. This makes focus on national security imperative. A robust national security architecture based on clear national security strategy is a precondition for achieving our developmental goals. All present here are going to be the leaders of the armed forces and civil services in India and outside, and will be responsible for ensuring the national security in their respective countries in all its dimensions. I'm sure the 1 year that you spend at this prestigious National Defense College will help you successfully navigate the challenges that the world faces while responding to your assignments. Distinguished audience, as global peace fractures, wars intensify, and hostilities harden into doctrine, all while climate crisis looms, humanity teeters on a precipice, salvation may lie in embracing India's ancient wisdom, millennia-old principles of harmony, tolerance, and coexistence. This could be mantra for the entire world to get a reprieve from existential challenges we are facing beyond climate change at the moment. To the distinguished officers from our friendly foreign countries, and I find they are one-third of this group and fairly representative from a global perspective, I hope that your stay in India has been comfortable and fruitful. I'm certain that you will go back to your respective countries with fond memories and nurture the bonds forged here. These bonds will hopefully help further strengthen the partnerships that India has with your great nations. I'm certain that you will all be proud alumni of the NDC. Distinguished audience, I'm confident and optimistic that you all over the years will contribute in the evolution of a more secure and habitable world for our future generations. I wish you luck in all your future endeavors. I pray your assignments are discharged with exemplification of highest virtues of commitment and dedication, and may you all and your families be blessed with good health and happiness. I am grateful to the Commandant for making available to me this audience that has a capacity to bring about the change, contribute to the change the world needs. Thank you so much.